more on this Tuesday morning. I wish you'd been here in the commercial break. Good friend of the show, Pete Quevelin, is here, director at Kidsport BC. We love having you on, but Riaz right now is admiring you from afar. The pocket square, the suit, the look, right down, right?
Bow down,
the props. There you go. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming here.
My pleasure.
You got some news this morning that might be unnerving for some, because we talk a lot with kids sport and every child should have the right to play. How do we get the kids out to do these activities regardless of their financial situation? But today's topic from Participaction is a report that has nothing to do with that. It's simply about moving and how we grade.
Yeah, it's the annual physical activity report card, and unfortunately it's a failing grade overall. We're seeing kids 3 to 4 year olds are getting the appropriate physical activity, but the 5 to 17 year olds, 9% of them are getting the appropriate physical activity in order for them to be healthy.
What do you think's at the root of that?
Well, Participaction's taken a real stand this year and said that a big component of that is the inability of parents to allow their kids to take risks, to tumble, to run around, to jump, to play, to climb, to roughhouse, that sort of thing, to go outside. Those things are real contributing factors that really haven't been addressed in the past.
What do you think is at the root of that? You know, there are helicopter parents, there are dolphin parents, there are tiger parents. Is it video games and it's just easier to plug them in? Or is it really the fact that I don't want my child going across the street to the park by themselves because somebody might grab them?
It's all of the above, I think, Jody. You have a greater chance of being hit by lightning than having a complete stranger abduct your child. So that's a false fear, I think. The fact that I think we're all sort of taking ownership of this thing, government, not-for-profit organizations, parents, we all have to be a little less litigious, perhaps, allow kids to take those risks, to climb a little bit higher than you think they should, to roughhouse a little bit. It's really important, I think, to allow them to understand what their limits really are.
Many of us of a certain age, I think we're collectively right around that. I mean, we used to run, it was like, come in when the street lights are on. Yeah. Why has that changed so much?
I think there's a fear of letting kids do that. And I think I've always said, get out with your kids, go out and play, run around, let them play tag, take them to the endowment lands and run around. I know you do that in the trails, and take them in the rain, take them in the snow, and don't be so afraid of that kind of thing.
Getting them wet and rolling them
Absolutely.
In it a little bit. It's kind of like that whole, you know, if I keep my child at home and germ free, they'll never catch anything. Well, they'll actually get it worse. Because you got to work that muscle.
Sure.
Now, when it does come to health and muscle and learning and cognitive learning, it is completely attached to physical.
Sure.
Wellness.
Yeah. Physical literacy is a real, and again, not such a great grade there. Kind of an incomplete, I would say. But it's that free play and letting kids explore their limits helps them to gain the confidence, to gain the skills that they need to do other things, to do organized sport. And so that's really important. You have to let them learn that physical literacy. You can teach some of it, but they need to explore it on their own as well.
And that's a great example, Pete, for somebody who's going, I don't know, when am I going to have time? How am I going to fit this in? Organized sport, you know, doesn't take a lot to just get the kid, whether they're tumbling at a gymnastics or perhaps playing basketball, you know.
And it's one of the pieces of the report card that gets a pretty good grade, actually. 70% of kids play organized sport. But it's a piece of the puzzle. It's not everything. There are a lot of other things. That sedentary behavior is still endemic. There's a lot of things that we need to change. And organized sport only plays a part of a role.
So if we're going to change one thing starting right now, what's the first thing you do?
Get kids outside.
Just
let them get outside.
Go down
after
low
dinner.
Tide, let them run around to the beach.
Turn the computer off, turn the TV off, turn the TV off, but
no,
get
you
outside.
Can say that. You can say that. You just don't turn it off when breakfast
That's
television
right.
is on
yeah.
because you're eating your breakfast, you're just having a moment, your coffee, you're learning.
Yes.
Then you watch CityLine, then you can just go
Correct.
For the day.
That's what I meant.